weeks when one night I was like covered in blood in my underwear stabbing him, and then I had to like drag him.
What's up, guys? Nikki Novak here in the Young Hollywood studio with Sara Paxton. Great to see you.
Great to see you.
Without too. Dustin, the last time
I
you
know,
were here.
I miss Dustin, my little my counterpart, my shark nanigans counterpart.
There was a lot of talk last time you were here about craft services and you being like the craft service queen, and then you came in here and you were chowing down.
I came here half an hour early just for the snacks. I was like, I had a plan because I've been to Young Hollywood and they have good snacks.
We have good snacks. Did you try the popcorn machine?
No, it was off. So I don't want to fire it up like, hey, girl.
Maybe they'll bring some in mid-interview so we can snack away. And then I asked you what you did during the Oscars and you said eat.
I ate in my bed. I was like, I'm going to get wild and eat a pizza in my bed. And I fell asleep like in the box.
Different kind of role for you, because I heard this is the first time you actually played a real person that, you know, exists.
And yes, exactly. Susan Wright is a real person, and in 2004, she was convicted of murdering her husband.
Just please stop.
Why are you crying, Susan? Does looking at this make you cry?
How could somebody not cry when they look at something like that?
How can somebody do that?
She stabbed him 193 times.
I play
she
Susan.
Was not a happy person.
She was not happy, no. So it was definitely the most challenging thing I've ever done, because I felt like I had to sort of, you know, I wanted it to be as authentic as possible because Susan's real.
And then I read too, like somebody asked you like what your thoughts were on whether or not she was actually guilty. Like, was she a murderer or was she just so beaten and abused and just that right. Somebody just eventually can't take anymore?
Yeah, well, it's really hard to say. I mean, Yeah. It's... One of the themes in the movie, I think, is, you know, when a person sort of reaches that breaking point, you know, what are human beings capable of once they've been pushed, you know, so far?
I already ate. I'm gonna go to bed. You don't bother coming in unless you want to act like a real wife.
I think that what's so great about this movie is you watch and you decide, you know, what side are you on? Some people may not agree with the prosecution.
So when you're shooting 193,
193
stab.
That, no, like known wounds, the ones that they could just that they could count.
Like once you've left the character behind and you're finished shooting, like what do you, you know, is that why you were eating pizza in bed?
No, that's like a reoccurring theme for me. but when we were filming the movie, we were like, we wrapped like the 23rd of December, so it was Christmas, you know, so I sort of right. Just like slunked into my bed at my parents' house and I was like, ah, take care of me. And they sort of like nurtured me back to health and they fed me a lot.
Big surprise.
Yeah, so it was sort of easy to leave it all behind when like Christmas was,
when
the holidays were right there.
When but happy time is coming up.
But it was exhausting. It was, we filmed the murder and the cover-up of the murder all in one night. So in one night, I was like covered in blood in my underwear stabbing him, and then I had to like drag him. They tried to like put palm olive or Pam or something on the wood floor so that I could drag him, but they didn't tell me. So I was like getting ready to like run, and I did like a Looney Tunes, like, like my feet started running, and I just...
Oh, your feet were slipping in the Crisco?
Yeah, so I just...
Instead of Justin. Justin was like...
Because I was like going, I was like ready, like my guns were out, I was like, I'm gonna drag this guy out there, and they didn't tell me that they waxed the floor, so I just was like, boom, and I flew down the hallway, which was entertaining for them.
So did I hear you're a history, are you a history buff?
When I was in school, I was obsessed with history, like I would stick around with my teacher, and I would do extra credit. Assignments, you know.
So the last time you were here, Dustin was bragging, I don't know if you remember this, about his bear skills.
His
about
bear
like
skills?
How to like tame a bear or something, and he was trying to put you to shame. So if you could teach us one thing about history that we don't know, what would it be?
George Washington Carver invented peanut butter. He made peanut butter. Yeah. Is that... Does anybody else know that?
How'd you know that? I didn't know that.
You didn't know that?
No.
Yeah, George Washington Carver. The other George Washington.
Right, not the...
He made peanut butter. Yeah. I'm really into useless facts when we... Obviously. Not just history, but I have like... When we were filming Shark Night, actually, Dustin would make fun of me all the time because I was reading this book called like 101 Useless Facts, and there's like three parts, and we'd be in the middle of a really dramatic scene and I'd just be like, did you know that
oh,
a whale
one.
Is called a dork?
What?
A whale is called a dork. I'm full of useless
So
facts.
I'm going to walk around LA from now on, and when I meet people I don't like, I'm going to call them a dork, but they have no idea why. They're going to be like, oh, that's such a nerd name, but
yeah,
no.
Yeah, you're going to be like, I know, that means we have
That's just mean, but I love it, Sara. Thank you very much for coming in and teaching us that information.
I think I topped Dustin on that one.
I think you kind of did.
Bears, schmears, right?